other participants will join, will not wait for them because I want you to cover one case study of your email. So we'll have to hurry up for that.
Yeah, Shruti, you can start. Students will join.
Yes, ma'am. I'm starting it now.
Yeah, sure. You can start.
Okay, now we have stop words also. Now, what are stop words in English? When we I have to make a statement or I have to tell you something. So we are using some connecting words like I, we, like I ate something, I'm eating. So I am here. What are these? These are the words which don't mean anything. I, we. So they are the words which don't have a specific meaning in your NLP library. So what this library do? So they are treated as a stop words over there because we are having the words which is providing information. So these words like I, we, so these kinds of words are not providing us any information. So that's why they are called stop words in NLP. And these are very helpful in NLP because when we don't want this results and why I want to include this word in my NLP library, right? So for removing this word, so let me show you what are these words which is already stored in library of NLTK. What are the stop words over there? So let me tell you what are the length of the stop words and what are the stop words which is already stored in that. Just open your Anaconda file. Good afternoon, Shiva. Good afternoon, everyone. Okay, so for that, what you have to do, just import this over here from nltk.corpus, import stop words. Now, I want to see what are the stop words which are already in my NLP library in natural language processing. So I want to see that. All right, so for that, command is nltk.corpus, import stop words. So I'll just, then after that, if you want to see what are the words in your NLTK library, which are stop words, which are treated as a stop words. So for that, we have I, me, my, myself, we are. Now you can see that these are the connecting English alphabets which we are using, that is I, me, myself. If they don't have a specific meaning or from which we can analyze something intelligent or we can analyze something useful. So that's why we don't treat them also. So that's why we are deleting them. So we should take them as a stop word. They have already a dictionary saved in NLTK library. So you just have to use that. So for that, what you have to do, right? First, this command you have to import words which is stored in your corpus library. And after that, if you want to see what are the words in that, so what you can use, stop words. Okay, I'll show one group, my 32 block also. Wait. Now can you see screen, Manru? Is it okay now? Okay, that's good. So what you have to do, if you want to see the stop word, just write stop words dot words. And because we want to see English, it's the language in which we want to see. So we are having a English. When you execute this, you will see this much we are having. Now when I scroll down over here, you can see over here, we have a plenty of stop words which are included in our NLTK library. All right, so I want to how many words they are having in this. Only Vishakha corpus is included. Only corpus, that command, the command which I told you that print one corpus only that should be executed. If it download wali agar aapki nahi chal rahi hai, that doesn't problem. We just include the print line of corpus jahan par hum print karwa rahe hain corpus ka na operating system se, just include, just run that line, uske baad ye run ho jayega aapka. Okay Vishakha. Now Now, what you have to do, just find the length. Then we are find using the length function over here. As you can see over that, we have total of 179 of stop words. So that's a great advantage that I just want to include that stop words. It will automatically delete my stop words because they don't derive any meaning, any specific meaning from that. So that's why these are called stop words over here. But in English, they are used for connection. So not here. So that's why we don't need, because we don't want to train our machine using these words that how or I am like this. So we don't want that. So we'll use these stop words over here. Now we have done. Try another language also, Sharma. Try another. You will get to see. Yes. Then. And what we have created one variable fdist. Overseen, you have already seen that the artificial intelligence data and the frequency which we have checked. Now I want to see the top 10 values of my frequency and the words which are used. So for that, command is fdist underscore top 10, right? We have done this command earlier also. So what you have to do, just see this, that and is using 5 times, intelligence is 4 times. Now o, a, the, dot, so these are the words which don't have any meaning. So these are the stop words over here, and I don't want these words, right? So what I have to do, and you can see the punctuation over here also. The punctuation, I'm having dot over here, comma over here, if you are having a semicolon or colon. So these are kind of the punctuations which you don't want also not include, because as you can see, okay, Vishakha, that's good. Now if it is running, now you can see over here that dot is coming 3 times. So these are kind of the stop words which I don't want include. So what you can do for that, just use punctuation. So for that, we have regular expression. Are you guys familiar with the regular expression? Say yes or no. Yes. Okay. No. Some are saying yes. Some are saying no. Okay. Don't worry. Now, what are regular expression? The expression like hyphen. These are the words which I don't want to include or which I don't want to compile. Okay. So I don't treat as a word for that. So what you have to do, you have to import one library, that is RE, that is your regular expression over here. And I have created one variable with the name punctuation, and I'm telling him that what you have to do, if you come to this, any kind of punctuation for that, you have to ignore it. You don't need to include that. Okay, so this is the way, and R over here is raw input. If you are getting raw input, so what you have to do, you have to scan the line and you have to find out these inputs in the input string. Then what you have to do, and you have to treat as a regular expression. You don't need to include that because I don't want that in my libraries, right? So this is the method which I have used, and you can see over here. What we have, it will remove the all the punctuation, the dot it is considering over here. So this is the way how you can remove that. Okay, so so first this is the way from where we can do that. Now let me first, we'll do some case study, then I'll tell you. Okay, then vectorization and what all this. So let's first done off from here. Yahan tak sabko samajh mein aaya? Just import regular expression. Yes, just type over here, import regular expression. Then we will do one case study first so that you can get idea from that. Okay, that's good. Okay, now let's start the case study, that is spam detection, right? So we want, what we want, we want to do, we have the data set of email. I want to check whether it's a spam mail or it's a ham mail, right? So let's start with that session first, so that the steps which we are gonna cover, it will include it in that. So for this, you need one library, one data set, that is spam.csv, right? So this is the data set. I have installed it earlier because I have this run this spam detection way before. So I'm using this file over here. Now, if you want to get this same CSV file, either you can get from your Kaggle account. I'll share Kaggle account with you. If there is no same data set you are getting from mine, then what you can do, I'll mail the file to you also. All right. So I'm sending the link of Kaggle also in the chat box. You can download the data from that. So we are having a spam data. Just download it first, then we'll continue. And when you download, there will be a one file with the name that is spam.csv. As you can see, now you can see we are having two columns over here. First, we are having column name with the V1 in which there is showing there is a ham or spam, right? Ham means inbox folder, that the mail will go to your inbox folder. And the spam, what does it mean? That it will go to your spam folder. Now, if we analyze the data from here, just read first email of ham, go until during point crazy available only in okay and great world. So there is nothing word which is having a negative impact, right? Now let's consider one spam mail also. In the third one, we are having a spam mail in which you can see free entry. I told you in which you are getting mails like free lottery. So these are kind of mail which are considered as spam. So you can see over here, we have a free entry. So this is considered as a spam. Now see the row 7 over here, free message. Here there are free message. So again, free, I'm getting the word right. Again, check spam. Had your mobile 11 months or more. So they are providing mobile cameras for free. Again, we are having a free keyword over here. So what it will do, it will find free lottery. These kind of word you can also find in your spam box. So this is the kind of the data set which we are working, which we have to work. Okay, has everyone done downloading the data set? Should we start now? Okay, that's good. What about others? Okay, that's great. Yes, everyone. Okay. Yeah, that's good. I have sent you the link, Nimrat. I have sent you the link in the chat box. Just download that. And I can send you the my same file as spam.csv file. I'll send you to Dr. Mukesh sir. You can get it from that. All right. Should we start now? Has everyone done? Should we start now? Okay. Okay, Tanish is saying wait. Okay. और किसका रह गया है वो? Has everyone done or should I wait? Okay, Tanish, I'll wait for 1 minute. Instead, everyone should type these. Just make your file readable. Make your file computer readable so that just import your CSV file in your Anaconda folder. Just do it with that part. Okay, just tell me one thing. I written over here that in CSV file encoding equal to Latin. So what does that mean? Yeah, tell me the meaning of that. Yes, we are using Latin encoding. So why we are using this? What is Latin encoding? Yeah, tell me. Okay, ISO 8859. I hope everyone should know about this Latin encoding. Yeah, it's ISO 8859. So should we start now? Type yes or no? Okay, so let's start now. Okay. Yes, Tanish. Okay. Okay, just what you have to do, first import NumPy, Panda, and because I have created another file, just imported these files, import NumPy, Pandas, and NLTK. Yes, traits convert text to some form readable by Python. Because if you are dealing with that character set, because you have a word and you have a string, so what you have to do, you have to include encoding method. Otherwise, in integer, your UFT8, we have earlier used that now. So in if you are having a words or characters, what you have to do, you have to include Latin over here to read the data, to read string and character words. So that's why we needed this encoding equal to Latin, right? So over here now you can see that after importing every libraries, what I want to do, I want to read my CSV file over here. I have already shown you how you can read the data CSV file. First you have to import CSV file in the same folder in which Anaconda is running, right? So we have done this part. Now we are creating a data frame, and I'm using read function for reading the CSV file. So spam.csv, and because my file that is spam.csv include characters, so I want to work on that, and it should be converted into some form that should be readable by Python. So that's why I have used encoding equal to Latin, right? So this is my encoding which I have used. Now what I want to see, I want to see top five values of my data set. So for that your command is here dot head. So these commands we already have used, so I'll not explain again. So here you can see the output over here. I am having a five. Now you can see over here we are having five columns over here, first with the V1 in which you are having, and another is V2 in which you are having the message, the data, and one is unnamed two, then three, and then four. Now maybe when you are getting the data, there may be a columns which are empty, because you can see over here NaN value. I have told you if you have a NaN value, what you have to do, because we don't want these columns, then what you have to do, then just remove this column. Now let's just see the shape of this column. When I executed the shape command over here, what I can see, there are 5,572 rows over here and five columns. But V1 and the V2 columns are my actual use, and I don't want to use this unnamed 3, 4, and 5. Now, when you see the database, there is only two columns, that is V1 and V2, which is named, and another which is not named. So that's why your Python given them unnamed, because they had don't have any head. So now what we have to do, we have to remove this. So but now in this project you will see we are using everything. First we have covered your matplotlib library, so we are using matplotlib library over here. And second we have done your which library? After matplotlib, which library we have done? Yes, tell me in chat box. OpenCV, okay. Yes, OpenCV we are not using here. Seaborn we can use. Yes, Panda we have done. So we are using Pandas also. NumPy. Yes, so Scikit. Yes, we are also using Scikit over here in NLTK. Now you will see we are having one project in which all the libraries which we have done, we are using now. So take it as a project, and you can do after this the projects which you want to do by using these various libraries. see over here, what I want to do now, I want to drop these columns with the jinke paas kya values hai, unnamed columns hai, right? So I don't want that. So for that, command is data frame dot drop and write the column. So they are the column name, which is because they have the column. So if you want to delete the columns, you also have to provide the close your mic, just turn off your mic, Mukesh. Yeah, now we'll see that. Just turn off your mic. Yeah, you can see the X's over here because we are deleting the columns. So you have to provide the X's. Now just print that head value. Now see that we are not having the columns unnamed. Now they are deleted, they are dropped already. So have you done till here? Type yes or no. Okay, sabka ho gaya yahan tak? Has everyone done that? Okay. Okay, that's good. Now come to this part. Okay, good. Has everyone done that now? Okay. Okay, let's continue. Vishakha, you are having an error. CSV file not exist. Did you import that file into your Anaconda folder, Vishakha? That's why you are having an error. CSV file not exist. Have you downloaded the data? Okay, okay. Just do it then. Okay, now what you have to do. Okay, let's see our data first. Then I'll tell you what we are doing. Okay. Yeah, in just a bit you will see in your screen the data. Yes, now you can see over here what we have. We have the mail message, and from that we are deriving whether it's a ham message, that is your inbox message, and that is your spam message. So what you have to do, you have to train and test your model. You will use one model in that, and you'll train your model according to the data I am providing, this data set. So when we train that and test that, and will predict whether what's the accuracy of the model which we built, which we have trained, whether it tells the good value or whether the false value, right? So this we have to do, and we have to check the accuracy also. But now here you can see over here the value I'm having, it's in the string form, it's not in your numeric form. But I told you earlier that the machine learning algorithms, if you want to apply, what you have to do, they must be in your numeric form. So how we can do that? Because our data is in the text form, that is in the string form. But machine learning algorithms can be applied only on your numeric form. So for that, what we have to do, type in chat box, what we have to do. Yes, participants, because we are doing one project now, so tell me what we have to do. Okay, convert it into Unicode. Yes, what else? Yes, I want everyone should reply what I have to do. Okay, no one is replying. I guess no one knows that. Okay, so let me just proceed with that. Yes, converted into numeric. Yes, we will convert it, and but we'll get, you'll get to see how I'm getting the output over here, right? So for that, we have a various functions in your NLTK. If I want to convert it into numeric form, so for that, just let's first convert it into that. But what I am doing, I am copying that folder, that is my V2 folder, because this is the value, this is the column from which I'll train my system, because I have to extract the information from here. Because when you see your V2 column, whether it contains free keyword or not, so you have to analyze this column. So for V2 column, I'll not work on the same column. What I'll do, just make a copy, because you have to convert it into numeric form. So it's a better way to convert it into to make a copy first, then you can do the calculations on that, right? So just what I have done, I have created this folder using the copy function, and I'm just copying this column in another variable with the name df_copy. Just first run this command, and we have another, I can say there is one function, there is one library which is called counter vectorizer. I'll explain what is counter vectorizer, and this is the step which is done after your tokenization and the lemmatization stemming. Okay, now because we are not having this much of data and tokenization in this project, we don't need that. So I'll tell you in another project how we do that, because that's why I've already explained you the tokenization and the lemmatization in that. Now what we have to do, we have to import that one library, that is counter vectorizer. So let's just first execute this command, and this is available in your sklearn library. So what you have to do, just write this command from sklearn dot feature extraction and dot text, right? So import counter vectorizer. So we are using counter vectorizer for that. Just first run this command, then I'll explain what it is doing over here. Yeah, has everyone done till here? Okay, I'll copy that. Okay, no problem. Okay, now let's see, because kya kya humne, we have these value, we have the string in the form like go until, we have this string, we have uploaded the data. Now our next task is we have to design the vocabulary. Now because all the unique words from these CSV file sentences, we have to ignore the cases, punctuation, then one character tokens, right? Because I don't want to include that, the punctuation, one character tokens, and the regular expression. So what I have to do, so I'll make one vocabulary from out of these words. And for making the vocabulary, I have to use this counter vectorizer class, right? So what I have to do, that's why I'm using count vectorizer class over here from the sklearn library, so that I can design our vocabulary. And I'll design my vocabulary from these words. जहाँ से हम frequency find out कर रहे थे ना कि ये word कितनी बार आ रहा है. So that's how I am creating one vocabulary. Now we'll see how we can use it and read it. Okay. So for that you need to score the words in each document. So the task here is to convert each row text, that is you are having the text over here in B2 column, and we have to convert it into a vector of numbers. You already know what is vector, we have already done that. So after that, what we can do, we can use these vectors as an input for a machine learning model, because I told you your machine learning model is working on your numerical data. So when we convert these value, this string into vector, so that vector will be now input for our machine learning model. So the simplest scoring we can do from that, either give them label also, like for if we are doing with the ham or spam, either give 1 or 0, like this we can also do that. But in here you can see I'm just doing that automatically, that it, I'll provide just using count vectorizer, and I've told them just do it that. Okay, so basically what we are doing, we are converting into a vectors of numbers. So we have done till here. Okay, now tell me, have you understood what count vectorization is doing? Type yes or no. Yes, participants, type yes or no. Okay. What about others? Okay, Shivam, no. Okay, Shakha, I'll explain again. No problem. Okay. Okay, no problem, Shreyash. I'll explain again. Okay, wait. I'll explain you with another example. Yeah. Not from this one. Yes. See over here. Yeah, this file. Now I have the words, for example, in your, wait, I'll show you my text file also, in which we have a 4 words so that you can understand better. Can you see the text file? Now in this, you can see we have a 4 lines. For example, I like this movie, it's funny. I hate this movie, this was awesome, I like it, nice one, I love.
Shruti ma'am, you are not audible.
Is it audible now? Still not audio? Okay. Okay.
Now you
are. Is
audible.
It audible now?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. Then good then. Now see over here, what I have to do first, include your file, just read that file that humne create ki. I like this movie, it's funny. We have the 4 lines over here. Now we are using count vectorization, and what it will do when I'll perform the count vectorization over here, what it will do, it will transform the documents into like value of this. Can you see over here output? Now हमारे पास इनपुट क्या थी, आई हैव ऑलरेडी सेंड यू द 4 लाइंस व्हिच आई एम हैविंग, दीस आर द 4 लाइंस. नाउ सी ओवर हियर, फर्स्ट वी हैव आई लाइक दिस मूवी इट्स फनी, आई हेट दिस मूवी, सो एवरी वर्ड, एंड वी विल नॉट इंक्लूड स्टॉप वर्ड. सो हियर इन द आउटपुट यू आर नॉट हैविंग द स्टॉप वर्ड्स लाइक योर आई एंड दिस इट, सो दिस इज अ स्टॉप वर्ड, सो वी शुड नॉट इंक्लूड दैट. बट ऑसम. And you can see over here, like this movie, so how many time it is repeating, it is giving the frequency of that. So see over here, it is converted into a vector. How it is converting it, awesome, because in it is treating as a line 0. This is first I'm having the row 0, then row 1, then row 2, then row 3. So in first row, awesome word is not coming, that's why output is 0. But in one row I'm not having again the word awesome, so that's why its value is 0. But in second, but in third row, that is the index value 2, you are having the word awesome, that's why its value is 1. So when you are having funny word only in the first row, that's why its output is 1. It is not in the other rows, that is output is 0. So So that's how your vectorization works. Your frequency, it will count in how many rows the same word is coming. So it will vectorize, it will work like this. So did you understand how it is working now? What is your vectorization, count vectorization is working? Type yes or no? Okay. Yes, Vishakha, is it clear now? Okay, that's good. Now again, let's come to your email, because we have to analyze the email now. So what we have to do, vectorizer is equal to count. Now I'm using one variable vectorizer and I'm calling the count vectorization function in that. Okay, I have just called that. After that, what you have to do, you have to use the fit function. We already use the fit function in sklearn library. So you know how this is doing, because we are vectorizing, we are fitting the function on this column df underscore copy. So we have fit that function. Now what you have to do, you have to transform it also. You have to change it in another form. So first what you have to do, you have to fit that, then after that transfer that. So I'll copy this command for you. So what you can do, just copy and paste in your Anaconda. Okay. So we have done till here your vectorization. Now your data all is converted into a vector form. Now you have to apply one algorithm so that you can see the accuracy, whether your algorithm is working for verifying whether it's a spam mail or a ham mail. Okay. So till here we have done. Now it's time for your sklearn library, and now we are using logistic regression. You can use linear also, but now here we are using logistic. Let's not go deep into what is logistic regression and that. Just analyze this data, because our main is our NLTK. So don't go into depth, just try to use your logistic regression model over here. Okay, is it clear till now? Type yes or no. And everyone has done that part. Okay. Sabka ho gaya jahan tak abhi kiya hai humne. We have just transformed it. Now it's time to create model. Now it's time to use that model. Okay. Okay, then great, because no one is having doubt. Now let's proceed further. What we have to do now, again from the sklearn library, from the linear model, because if you are importing logistic, it's again from the linear model. So just use this command sklearn.linear_model and import logistic regression. So we are doing an algorithm for this logistic regression, because when you have a value, when you want to find out whether it's a spam mail or a ham mail, or when you want to find out whether you have the disease or not, like a binary, so that time that better algorithm is you should be used is like logistic regression. So that's why we have used logistic regression over here. And I have used another metric in sklearn. We have another class matrix, and I'm using that and importing accuracy score. Now I want to see whether the model logistic regression, how much accurate it is providing my score. So that's I want to check. So that's why I have used include this metric also. Now for model selection, as you already know, in sklearn we have to divide the data into two parts. First is your training part and the second is your testing part. So for that dividing and for splitting, we have the function train and test, right? So we just included model selection, import train and test. So just import three lines first, then we'll do after that. Yeah, I've just copied that line into your chat box. Just run these lines. Is anyone in getting error or not? Or everyone executed that? Are you doing with me now, or you will do after my session? Done, ma'am. That's great. Okay, tell me, you are doing with me now, or you will show you will do after my lecture with you. Okay, that's great. Doing side by side, that would be very great, because if you're doing Okay, this is the code, but which code you want to see? Because everything I have written over here. That's good, Shreyash. We're doing side by side. 1 and 2. Okay, Bhavya. See over here and then. My first is I'm just importing NumPy. I'll explain Shiva more in random. I'll also explain in earlier session. I'll explain it again. Don't worry. Okay, Bhavya. This is my second column. I have dropped that. Is it okay now? Okay, no problem. Okay, let's move further. यहाँ तक सबका हो गया है. Now your data we have to divide it into because we have two columns, V1 and V2, and we have to split into that. So for splitting, what you have to do, you have to create 4 parameters. One for your V1 column you are having, then we divide it into train and test. Again, V2 column you are having, then divide it into train and test. Right. So here I have divided into, I have taken first V2 underscore train, my first column, my first variable, then V2 underscore test. And another is V1 train and V1 test. Right. So we are having these value. So I'll divide data into these 4 columns over here, and the data will automatically go into that when I'll apply train and test splits function. Now see in the train and test splits function, what are the values we have to give? Now when I call train and test splits function over here, first over C we have supplied the vector over here. Now what is vector? The variable over C you can see over there. The value which we have already converted into the vector form, right? So because you are passing the vector value now, you are not passing the actual column, that the string value, you are passing the vector's value. So that's why I have given that all the values are converted, that is your data is converted into a vector form now. So then again, what you have to, because your vector include only your V2 column, right? So now I have to give the V1 column for that. So that's why I have given V1 column over here and the test size. Now see over here, what should be the test size now? Now it depends on you. I have taken 0.15, that is 15% should be your test size, and 100 minus 15, it will be your training size, right? So you can do either test size take 0.20, that means your 80% will go to your training data and your 20% will go your test data. So if you have a problem and if you are doing one project, the changes you can make is that in the same project which we are doing, you can change the algorithm. Instead of naive, instead of logistic regression, try to implement naive Bayes algorithm. Okay, and the second one, we are doing the test size, you can change it also and check the accuracy. So these are things which you can do after changing that. And we are saying the random state 42. So they are having a different random state for a different algorithm. When we have used linear regression, we have given random state equal to 42. Did you remember? When we have used linear regression, we have given random state equal to 42. Did you remember? Say yes or no. Type yes or no. Okay, now tell me, okay, who are saying yes, why we have used 42 over there, why we have used? Now tell me, yes, why we have used that? Yes, tell me. Okay, no one is replying, I guess. No one knows that why we have done random state. Okay, I'll tell you random state why we have done every time, because the value, the data which is splitting into training and the testing set, it is automatically done by your algorithm, right? So every time when you execute your code, your model will run and it will divide your training and testing data again and again into two different parts. So I don't want every time when I run this command, I am getting data different. So what I want, the data should remain same into training and the testing part whenever I am running or executing the part. So that's why in linear regression, we have said that the random state equal to 42, and now in this random state equal to 20, because we are using our logistic regression. Now is it understood why I have used that? Type yes or no. Okay. Yeah, it will prevent overfitting also, and the reason I that will also be done, Shreya. But the reason I explain that is also go with this. It will also use for that. Otherwise, if you don't give random state, try to give. It will give you another value also. It will give you another value every time. Try to run that also. So that's also the reason for that. Okay, now let's okay, I'll copy this command for you. Yeah, over here now just execute this command. Now what I have to do, I have to use the model. Now I have import the model, and also I have divide my data into training and the testing part, right? Now what I have to do, I have to apply the algorithm, I have to apply the model. So for that I am creating one variable with the SAM underscore model, and in this I am using logistic regression. And here I have given solver equal to LibLinear. Now what does it mean, solver equal to LibLinear? This is a classifier. Okay, the there are various type of classifier over that, but I want to implement the class I want to implement, that is logistic regression should use LibLinear library. We have various library like Newton CG, SAG, Saga. So there are various solvers which we have. But I want to apply regularization. So what I want to handle both dense and the sparse input. So that's why I have applied LibLinear, that you have to use these solvers over here for converting that and for applying the regularization. Okay, so this is done. After that, what you have to do, again fit the model. We have used SPAM model. अभी से हम क्या करा रहे हैं, फिट करा रहे हैं विद द टू वैल्यूज यू हैव, द टू पैरामीटर्स यू हैव टू पास. द फर्स्ट पैरामीटर यू हैव टू पास इज द V2 ट्रेनिंग सेट, ओके, एंड द V1 ट्रेन सेट. सो यू हैव द ट्रेनिंग डेटा, नाउ यू हैव टू फिट द मॉडल. अब हमारा ट्रेन हो रहा है मॉडल, वी हैव द फिट ऑलरेडी द मॉडल. नाउ व्हाट यू वांट टू डू, यू वांट टू you have the training data also. According to that we have trained our machine. Now I want to check, I want to test whether my machine has got some knowledge or whether it will predict true or false, right? So for that I have created one another variable, vi.predict. This is for predicting the value. So over here I am using the predict method. So SPAM model, we are using predict method over here. So you are having predict method, and in this how you can say that how you can predict some value. So we for predicting some value we have to pass the test data. So we are passing the test data is V2 test. So we are passing the V2 test data, that is in which you are having the inbox message like hi, I am this, or free messages like this. So when I supply like this, you will get the V1. So you will get the V1 predicted value, whether it's a spam mail or a ham mail. So that's how it will work, right? So now if I that's already done. Now if I want to check my accuracy score, now your accuracy will be calculated. How you can say that your model is accurate or not, it will depend on two parameters. What are the two parameters? Because we are finding whether it's a spam mail or a ham mail, that is your V1 column. So for in V1 column, we are having the test data, that test data which we have taken, and the predicted data. So according to test data, what my model predicted, whether it's ham male or a spam male. So we will compare both the values, the test values and the predicted value, and it will give us the accuracy score. So I'll just print my accuracy score over here. Now just see the output. We are getting 98% accuracy. This is a very huge accuracy, because this accuracy is not much possible, because the data I'm having, it is very good. So that's why, and I'm applying a good algorithm in that. So that's why we're having a 98% accuracy for that. So this is still accuracy, how we can find accuracy and all the value. I'll show you the values also and how you can use matplotlib. But just tell me, have you understood till part we have done till here? Have you any doubt till here? Just tell me, have you any doubt till here? Just type yes or no, because this is very important. I'll also copy the code for you after this. Okay, so this is the code. Just run it and tell me what accuracy are you getting. Okay, Aman, I'll explain it again. So for others, okay, Manroop, I'll explain the solver. Okay, I'll explain Vishakha. Just copy this, run these commands, and I'll tell you what we are doing. So first, let's revise that what we have done till here. We first, what we have data, we have to import various libraries like NumPy, Pandas, and NTK, which we are needed for our session, which we are needed for our project. Okay, so we have imported that library, and the data set I'm having is spam.csv. So I have uploaded that data set because they are having data in my this form, that is a string form. That's why I have included importing equal to latin. So because we are having in data sets, we are having also this unnamed column. So what I have to do, I have to remove because they're of no use. So with the drop command, I have deleted that value also. I have deleted the column. Now what I have to do, now see the database in V1 and V2. Now you are only having the two columns. And the project we are doing is this, whether you have to decide it's a ham mail or a spam mail, right? So output, so your value, your feature is your V2, and your output, that is your target value, is your V1. So last time humne sklearn library mein kiya tha, that is our feature and our target value. So from database you can get that V2 column is your feature value and the V1 is your target value, right? So you can also use linear regression in that. We are having these values. So now we want to extract information whether it will work or not, right? So when you are working on this, just remember your machine learning will not work on your directly on your string input. So what you have to do, you have to change it into vectors. So for changing into vectors, what I am doing, I am using one function, one class, that is with the name count vectorizer. So this is the class which I am using, and it is importing from the sklearn library. So I have used this function, and I have just fit the column into this, and I have created my vectors value. So I already explained this in detail, how you can create vectors value and how you can see that and how it will work. Now for the column of V2, like your the column of the feature, I have already converted into your the value of your vectors. Now we have the data in vector form. What I have to do, I have to apply some algorithm to calculate the accuracy, whether it will perform good or not, right? So for that I am using logistic regression. We have already done sklearn library. So from sklearn linear model, I am importing logistic regression. So I am putting this logistic regression over here because I also want to see the accuracy. So these are the parameters which I want to include. So accuracy score, or also you can use accuracy score from your matrix input from your matrix class over there. Okay. So and one more thing you have to import is your training and testing split function, which is in the model selection of your sklearn. So just import these libraries, and again now we have the data set. What we have to do, we have to train the data. Now whole data should be divided into a two parts, that is your training and the testing part. So we have divided, we have to create four columns now. First is your v2 train data, v2 test data, v1 train data, v1 test data, right? So we have created these four columns, and the value will go into that. Now, in the when you will call train test split function, what will happen? The vector value. You can see over here the vector value, which is, that is you are passing the vector data, your DF, the in the v2 which we have supplied. So it will go to your training data set. Then v1 value, so you are having the because we didn't provide the we didn't vectorize into that, so it will done it automatically when it will training and testing splitting the function. So we are providing the v1 column over here because that is the value, that is I have to give my target, because you have the target also, you have to explain whether it's a ham mail or a spam mail. So that's why we have given this column. And the test size and the random. Okay, so we have explained till this now. And now when you you have to create a model. Now we are using one variable, spam.model, and I'm calling logistic regression. Now you don't need to write whole code of logistic regression, how it works and how it will done. So what you have to do, just write logistic regression. And in this, I'm writing one solver with the name liblinear. You have another solver also, like SAG, SAG, or SAGA, SAGA, or Newton-CG. So these are the logistic regression. Why we are implemented? Because we want the regularization is to be implemented by default. Okay. So I want to implement the regularization. The words I am getting, because you have the data which is in the form of your text. So I want to regularize the data, that I want both values, that the dense value and the sparse value should be handled. So for this, I am using the value over here, that solver is equal to liblinear. Okay. So that's why I have used this solver over here. But if you use Newton CG or SAG or any other solver, you will not get any regularization. So that's why I want regularization. That's why I have used solver equal to liblinear. So is it understood now? Okay, that's great. Then what I have to do, then, okay, that's great. Now then what we'll do, we'll just fit our model and we'll predict our value. So when we'll predict our value over there, so we just predict the value from the test value. And we have two columns. On the basis of that, we have to find the accuracy. So when you have to find the accuracy, there should be the test value which on which you have performed the test, and the predicted value on the basis of the test which have come, right? So you are having these two columns over here. So when I'll print that, accuracy will calculate the accuracy score, and it is printing the 98%. So this is a very good accuracy which I am getting. Now I'll show you the actual and the predicted, that is in data frame. Now I'm creating one data frame to show you that how it, we can choose the accuracy. Kaise accuracy you are getting 98%. Now see over here, we calculate the accuracy on the basis of two columns. One is V1 test and one is V1 predicted. I told you V1 is your target. So you have to see that two columns over here, V1 test and V1 predicted. So this is the actual value, V1 test, on which we the data which comes from the data set, and predicted, V1 predicted is the value which is done with the help of our model. The model which we created, it predict whether the mail we supply for testing, whether it's a ham mail or the spam mail. Now we'll compare both the males with each other. So what I have done, I have created one data frame and I have passed two values over here, and I have given the heading actual and the predicted. So I'm showing you the 40 rows over here, just printing the head value. Now you can see over here we have these values over here. Now just find in the actual value, that is when we have done the testing in the actual database, we are having the ham value. And when you predicted the value, it again come ham. So that means the our model is doing right. So again you can see that ham. When I have the database, in my database I'm having the ham value and it also predicting the ham value, but it is giving me 98% accuracy. That means two value must be incorrect in that. So let's just find the two value. If there is a ham, it is spam value. Okay, so let's just find that. Yeah, see over here in row 5466, my male was spam and my predicted value, my model say that it's a ham value, so it gives incorrect value. So that's why here it gives incorrect value. So will not that's why your one is detected for accuracy. And there will be one another more value, one more row in which prediction will be false, right? So that's why we have seen that why my accuracy comes like that, 98%, because when I'm doing prediction, only two values come false, everything would be true. So that's why I have got 98% accuracy. So when I pie plot this, you can see we are having a linear graph because only a two values, because only two values is mismatched and it comes a linear graph over here. So tell me, have you understand this? Okay, so have everyone done till here? Practical also, has everyone done? Okay, that's good. What about others? Okay. Because you have taken the different data set, tell me your accuracy score, because your data set is not same as mine, so you will get a different accuracy score. So tell me your accuracy score in the chat box. Okay, Shreyas, you are getting 98. Okay, Kalpana is also getting 98. That's good. What about others? Yes, Kushagra, I can scroll up. You can see that code. Which block you want to see, Kushagra? Okay, but okay, that's good. Everyone is getting good. Okay, fourth one. Yeah, you can see that. That's very good. 98% accuracy everyone is getting. Okay, I'll just explain one more topic, but before that, just do change. Has everyone given 0.15 that value for splitting? Change it into 0.25, the value which we have given test for. I'll explain where you have to change. The test size I am having over here is 0.15. Just change it into 0.25 and again run it and tell me what is the accuracy now. After changing the training and the testing part, accuracy can be decreased. Okay, it is after changing into okay, tell me, it is after changing your test and train value, test score, it's after this. Okay, then let's again change it into, we have changed it into 25. Okay, let's change it into 0.5. let's try that. Still same, you are getting because our data set. Because our data set is having the good value, because our data set is good and the algorithm. The second is the algorithm we are choosing, it's giving the good value for logistic regression. So instead of changing the test size, now we see that we are algorithm is working fine, because if we change the value, that doesn't have any effect. So what you have to do, you have to change the algorithm. So wait, I'll change the algorithm also, but before that we have to done confusion matrix. Do you know what is confusion matrix? Okay. Okay, this is the last topic which we covered, so don't worry, I'll because after that we will take questions. So we have just one topic, so you can relax. Okay, so let's just confusion matrix. I'll explain what is confusion matrix now. So let's I'll explain with this example of a confusion matrix for a binary classifier. Because for example, I'm having a total number of rows in 165, right? And the confusion matrix, it will be draw like this. You are getting the value in the format like this in the matrix, which is in the 2x2 form, right? So the value, now see over here, it is the column, it is the for your actual value, that is actual no, and this is actual yes, and this is predicted no, and this is predicted yes. Now it is for our, because we have two possible predicted cases, either yes or no, right? Because it's a whether it's a person having a disease or not. So yes, it means person is having a disease, or no, person is not having a disease. So instead of no or yes, you can also use ham and them, which we are using in our project. But I'm explaining this example whether the person is having disease, yes or no. So here you have actual value and here we have a predicted value. So in actual value, you are first having no, then yes. And again in predicting, first is you are having no and yes. And it will be fixed, right? So what you have to do in actual value, you are having a no. That means you are saying that person is not having a disease. And it also predicted the same, that the person is having no, is not having a disease, right? And in actual, we are saying the person is not having a disease. In actual, the person is not having a disease. But it predicted, yes, the person is having disease. So, usne kya kiya? Galat bataya. So 10 rows, the 10 values which they have told about that the person is having disease, it's wrong. It's false values over that. Now, when it's the actual value, yes, that the person is having disease, yes, but it predicted no, that the person is having, again, the false value, but it's opposite. So that type of value, we are having a 5. And when the person is saying the actual, the value in the database is having yes, and it also predicted the yes. So that is, if I see over here, the total value, that is 5 over here, and the value over here, you can see a note of this one, yes, 10 value. The 10 and the 5, the total of 15 value, it has declared false, right? So total, this ne galat answers bataye hain, so this is the wrong answers which they have given, that they have predicted. So in this, so there are two we have done whether the person is having a disease or not. So total classifier made of 165 predictions, and so out of 165 cases, as you can see, 110 times it predicted yes and 55 times it predicted no. But in reality, 105 patient in the sample have the disease and 60 patients do not have the disease. So we have told them also that it's the value we have taken for that. Okay, so here we can say that this is a true negative value, this is false positive, false negative, true positive. So these are kind of values I am getting from that. So why we are using this confusion matrix? Because it will add the term how many values you are getting correct and how many values you are not getting correct. So confusion matrix is very useful in your logistic type of regression or binary type of regression in which you need that data, right? So we have implemented confusion matrix over here. Now first tell me, have you all understood what is confusion matrix? Type yes or no. What is confusion matrix? Have everyone understood that? Okay. Okay, that's good. What about others? Okay, that's good. Okay, now let's just implement it this. So again, confusion matrix is derived, we have to import it from the sklearn matrix library, and we are also using, because confusion matrix is done with the help of seaborn, that is your SNS library. So over here, because I want to create the confusion matrix between the two value, that is the v-test test and the prediction, which I have already shown you the two which I am getting the incorrect value. Now just I have printed the result. Now you can see the confusion matrix over here, 7261801. Now what does it mean? That I told you, yahan par aapki kya aati hai, that the person, here you are having the test value and here you are having the predicted value, right? So for now you are saying in this ham value, first is ham, then is your spam. So I have said that 726, they are saying it's a ham value actual wala, and predicted it is saying that it is your ham value. So 726 is your correct value, and one in one case over here you can see over that in this what I am getting, yeah, in this you are see over here that I have said that I am having a ham value, but it's a spam value. So that's not incorrect, that's why I have value like this. So here also you can see that why I'm getting the value. So here just is a diagram representation, you can see over that, and this is my ham value, this is my spam value, and this is again my value which are not. So they have described it very beautifully in the form of this graphic. I'll show you what it is done. So this, what you have to do, this you have to make this value, yes, just write this one or take a photo, actual, predicted, actual no and predicted no, actual no and the predicted. So these two are the negative value which I'm not getting, so that's why my block was black over this, and this is the true value which I'm getting. So just click this photograph, so you'll be able to understand why I'm getting black box over here, because these are the false value and these are the true values over here. So I hope you have understood the confusion matrix, how we can draw. I'll show you the code and you can run the code by yourself also. Yeah, I'll have sent the code, just copy and paste that. And you get to know, and there is nothing in which you don't understand, because we have done that everything. Okay, has everyone done that till here? Okay, that's good. Okay, that's good. So this was. Okay, Vishakha, I'll explain the last code. Okay, anyone is having the problem in the last code? Anyone else is having the same problem in the last code? Okay, that's good. Okay, I'll explain now so that I can move your question answer, and one task for you which you can done by yourself now. Vishakha, see over here, first I am importing the confusion matrix, and it will be drawn with the help of your seaborn library, and I'm storing the confusion matrix result, the values in the result column over here, and I'm just printing the result. Now you can see over here we are getting the output. Now, if you want to draw the confusion matrix in the diagram, you can do with the help of pandas, because I have used pandas, that is a DTD, so dot cross tab, because I want to in the form of the cross tab. So the function over here I have used is the cross tab, and I have to give the value, because the confusion matrix is drawn between your test value and the predicted value. So I have passed the variable, and the row name I want to give the label, it's actual, and the column name I want to give, it's your but I want to give the column name, that's the predicted, right? So I have given that over here. And in that SNS.heatmap, when you want to draw a matrix like this, then you have to use a heat map function in SNS. So in SNS, I have given that. I have given the confusion matrix, that the whole matrix which I have created, I have passed that. And I have given that annotation is equal to true, and I have given the FMT, that the value you have to use is D, okay, the format. So if you don't write this, don't worry, it will also get printed. Just focus that the title we have given confusion matrix, and now we are plotting the graph. So the main is over is confusion matrix is equal to cross tab, in which we are passing the two variables, that is the test function and the prediction function over here. So I want to just create over that, and also given the row name and the column names, which is the actual and that. And then as in heat map, the function we are having for drawing that confusion matrix, just pass the value on that. So I hope confusion matrix is clear to everyone. Okay, Vishakha, that's good. Okay, everyone is having any doubt? If you have any doubt regarding this, the today session, you can ask. Okay, that's good. No doubt. Okay. Okay, Harshvir is asking, okay, and FMT. So, okay, then first tell me, what do you mean by anode first? Have you understood what is anode? Annotation, yes, annotation. So we are saying it's yes, we are having the true value for that. Yes, that's good. This is annotation. So so we have FMT is your format string syntax. Okay, so we are giving the value over here. FMT is your format string syntax. So we are passing the value, either you can pass the value G or capital G. I'll show you also. I have implemented, but because we don't have much time for that, now here you can see over here the algos. I'm, because I was going to with the task for that, just let me show you the other algorithm. First I have used OK logistic over here again. Yeah, logistic I have used another one also as a metric. Okay, again I have used this one. Yes, you can apply the algorithm. The algorithm is naive Bayes linear algorithm. You can also apply. Okay, and the algorithm which will give the output in the binary, that is in the 0 and the 1, whether it's a spam or a ham, I will give you that notes for that. So don't worry about that, because we have a plenty of algorithms. Okay, Shrey, and okay, acha, I was explaining FMT, sorry, that was is you're having a format string syntax, so in which format you want that. So either you can give a small g or a capital G. So it's a conversion, how you can remove the zero from the result, or the minimum field width, how you can take that. So that specify the formatting, just it's a syntax for that. So just don't go into deep. Just remember, it's a format string syntax, how you can format your string. Okay, is it understood now? Okay, that's good, Harshvi. Okay, yes, count factorizer used for NLP, because when you want to convert, it's stored in that library, that is from coming from your sklearn. but actually we are using in NLP library, because you don't, you need only need to convert in NLP library over that. And Anushka, okay, I'll just copy this code for you, a regular expression. Let me just wait for this. Let me just find that code where I have used this one.
Ma'am, is it over? The session is
No, ma'am, we are discussing questions now.
Okay.
I'm asking questions from them.
Okay, yeah, sure. Okay, yes. The student session is open for the questions. Kindly ask your queries.
Okay, just let me find that. Okay, so which block do you remember? Regular expression in which block we are having? I'll just find another way or for you otherwise. Yeah, this getting your mic. I'll just copy and paste this code for you for regular expression. Yeah. So take this one. Okay, okay. We have done that. Now tell me if anyone is having any questions or how, because we have done everything. If you want to discuss your project also or what you want to do, okay, Anushka, what we are doing, because I don't want to, I'm telling my compiler that these are the regular expression which you don't need to include. So for example, hyphen, comma, so these are not the words. These are the punctuations used over here. So there is no specific meaning coming out of from this. So I just want to remove this regular expression, which is of the these format. So I have just applied that hyphen, comma, question mark, exclamation. So these are the kind of I have given that the regular expression, which you don't need to include in your, when you are compiling, so these considered should be as punctuation, because we are only dealing with the text data. So that's why I don't want to include this regular expression. So I'm just compiling, don't include that. So it, yes, we are taking raw string. Yes, R is used to take a raw string for that. Okay, Anushka. Okay, if anyone wants to discuss their project or even these projects which we have done today, is also we can improvise it. We can done we can improve this also. How we can improve? But you are getting 98% accuracy. That's for a one data set. You can apply for another data set. Or if you want to discuss any other project also, you can also do that. And if you have any doubt, any question you want to ask, you can ask that also. And tell me how you find your 5-day session, whether is what is it interesting, you find it interesting and you gain some useful information from this. Tell me your feedback.
Okay, students,
gain something, just type it.
Or anybody, if anybody want to talk, he or she can give the feedback.
Okay, that's good. Okay.
So ma'am, we are getting a very positive feedback for your sessions.
Okay.
That's good that students are able to understand the concepts, and even today's sessions was very informative. Like this one, I have just attended this.
Okay, thank you so much. Okay, thank you everyone for your feedback. Yes, I'll share my own notes with the Dr. Mukesh sir, and they will give it to you. Okay, I'll share with Dr. Mukesh sir.
Okay, students, kindly keep in touch with ma'am and also try to implement the concept.
Shruti, this really.
Yes, sir.
Okay, sir.
Okay, Shruti ji, thank you very much. Really, hello.
Yes, sir. Good afternoon.
Yeah. Good afternoon, Shruti ji. You really did a great job. Just by I am going through the feedback being shared by the participants, really very happy to read it out, and great appreciations for you.
Thank you so
and
much.
And definitely we are in touch with you for our next workshops, next courses to be conducted in near future under the same center. So thanks a lot.
Thank you so much, sir, for inviting me. That's a privilege for me. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you very much.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much. Thank you, Harshree. Thank